Chapter Networking. Hello student, today we will learn about computer networking. Student, let's understand what is a network. Students, in your daily life, you come across different types of networks. For example, if you look around, you will find network of roads, interstate highways, railway tracks, canals, cables, etc., which are spread across and interconnected to each other. Communication network of telephone system that enables you to talk to anyone, anywhere and anytime. Network of banks or ATMs that allow you to access your account anywhere around the globe. Radio or television network that broadcasts programs live across the globe. Network of hospitals, schools and malls all over the country. Similarly, when two or more computers are connected with each other, they together form a computer network. These linked computers share information with each other over the network. The internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks that enables users to share information and various resources with each other. The advent of the internet has proved to be a boon to this world. It is one of the largest information databases and has become a vital part of our life. It uses common interfaces to provide a physical backbone for many interesting applications. The blooming technologies of the modern age have made our life much easier and more connected across the globe via the interconnected networks. Let us understand computer network and its components. A computer network is a group of computers and peripheral devices connected through a data communication system. A computer network facilitates the sharing of hardware and software resources among different users working on different computers. These shared resources can be data files, any application software or hardware devices like printers, modems, etc. For example, if one of the computers in a network has a printer attached to it, then all the computers in that network can access the printer and use it to print the documents shown in figure, where computer A and B in a network can give the print command to the printer attached with computer C. Student, let's understand need of networking. The rapid evolution in information and communication technologies has generated the need to use the same data at different locations. One way of doing so is to keep the same data files at separate locations across the globe. This involves frequent transferring of data from one computer to multiple computers which are present at the same or distant locations. The continuous data transfer is a costly affair which results in redundancy of data and increased storage cost. In a data communication system, a message is transferred from one point to another via a medium. The sender creates a message, the medium carries the message, and the receiver, sometimes called as sync, receives the message. Let us understand with the help of an example. Suppose you want to communicate with your friend. Since you have some information to pass on to your friend, so in this communication system, you will be a sender. A sender needs a carrier to transmit information to the receiver. So, air is the carrier or the communication medium and your friend is the receiver who receives the information. Similarly, in case of a computer network, the computer which sends information is called a sender. Various mediums like cables, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, radio waves, etc. that are used to transmit information are the carriers or communication medium, and the computer which receives the information is the receiver. When a computers communicate over a network, three components are involved in the communication. 1. Sender. A sender is a computer, workstation, mobile phone or tablet that sends the data through the web browser. Number 2. Communication medium, carrier. It is the physical path through which the message travels from the sender to the receiver. It can be a cable, wireless device or protocols. Number 3. Receiver. A receiver is a device that receives the data message. It can also be a computer, workstation, tablet or mobile phone. Let us talk about advantages of network. In a computer network, information is usually stored at a central location. The aim of networking is to share resources. Computer network brings more efficiency, economy and effectiveness in an organization. The key advantages of networking are hardware sharing. In a network, we can share almost every peripheral device such as printer, scanner, modem, CD writer, etc. among several computers. All these devices are attached to a remote server which is shared among multiple computers. This reduces the cost of hardware. Software sharing. Every application software can be installed on the main server rather than installing it on every computer individually. Computers in a network can use the required software from the server. This technique saves costs as well as time. Students, let us know more. ICT is used as a general term for all kinds of technologies which enable users to create, access and manipulate information. ICT is a combination of information and communication technology. Efficiency of hardware and software resources. In a network, modifications in software or hardware are done at a single point. Since the resources are installed at a single point, all modifications are done at that point rather than individual computers. Reduces redundancy. Since people use the same data in a common workplace, they can share it over a network by saving and storing it centrally. This also reduces the redundancy of the same data. Saves paper and time. Networks also reduce the need for generating multiple hard copies of the same document. People working in a common workplace can share reports through the network, which saves both time and paper. Internet sharing. A network reduces the cost of installing internet facility into individual computer. A corporate internet connection is powerful enough to provide this facility to all computers in a network. All systems can enjoy the benefits of internet in a network. Security. Since the server contains all the software, the security of the server is of great importance. Common server security issues faced are weak passwords, open network ports, old software version, poor physical security, stale and unnecessary accounts. Let us learn about types of network. There are four basic types of computer networks. Number one, LAN. Number two, MAN. Number three, WAN. Number four, PAN. Number one, local area network, LAN. Local area network is used when two or more computers or peripheral devices are connected within a small area like a room, office building or a campus. The maximum range of LAN can be 10 km. The number of computers in a LAN varies from 2 to 1000. The hardware as well as software resources are shared through LAN. A LAN consists of the following components: two or more computers, software to control the operation of computers, peripheral devices like printers, scanners, etc., cables to connect the computers. Number two, Metropolitan Area Network, MAN. Metropolitan Area Network is much larger than a LAN setup and is spread across a city. Since it can cover an entire city, it is called MAN. The most common example of a MAN-type network in our daily life is cable television network. The main purpose of a MAN is also to share hardware and software resources. The maximum range of MAN can be 50 km. Number 3. Wide Area Network, WAN. Wide Area Network comes into picture when we have two or more computers located at faraway places linked by communication facilities like telecommunication or satellite signals. The most common example of a WAN network in our daily life is the internet, which is generally used in houses, schools, banks, in private and public sector. The main characteristics of WAN is that it requires a public telecommunication media to transfer data. Number 4. Personal Area Network, PAN. This type of computer network is mainly created for an individual person. It consists of a desktop or laptop computer, a mobile phone and or a handheld computing device such as a PDA or a smartphone. You can use these networks to transfer files including email, calendar appointments, digital photos and music. Personal area networks generally cover a range of less than 10 meters, about 30 feet. Student.